here to talk about it with me too.
Let's talk now a little bit about human variation. And I'm trying not to get on my little, you know, soapbox too much, since I have so many people's attention. It's rather tempting. But I think I just want to make note of the fact that the people are different. So one of the best things about working in a cadaver lab for 12 years is that you see how different people really are. Because you know what? The textbooks look the same all the time, right? I don't know how that works, but the textbooks just keep showing us the same images, and they don't show us the real variation that exists, right? And so sometimes there's a concern about normality. Am I normal? I don't look like this textbook, so am I normal? And so I really think it's important to, A, expect differences. Right? Anatomy is all about human variation. And so those of you in the room that have had a chance to study that and appreciate that in the amazing human cadavers that we have to study from, I think you've already taken that gem with you, but I hope the rest of you do, and consider it in terms of sexuality and orgasm, right? So I like to think of it as it's a mystery. Should you meet someone new and establish a new relationship, don't expect them to be like the last person you're with or look the same or experience the same thing. So my suggestion is to really think about people as unique. Their experience, their anatomy will be unique. Their experience will be unique. And like, it's probably not a bad idea to just ask some questions, right? Actually interact with them, explore, communicate. These things can happen, but they don't all the time, right? So it's great that you're all here to talk about it today, but sometimes we aren't good at talking to the person we need to be talking to. So I hope, again, that's my little soapbox for, you know, expect differences and enjoy the mystery and unravel it with the partner that you've chosen at that time, okay? So again, that's sort of soapboxy.